Hi everyone, welcome to the Combined DNA Technology. And today we're gonna learn about a very interesting topic, which is the introduction to recombinant DNA technology. Okay, so let's begin. Your learning outcome would be define recombinant DNA technology, and then to define the tool used in recombinant DNA technology, which is the target DNA, origin of interest, restriction enzyme, DNA calling vector, host cell, and modifying enzyme. If you take a gene from this firefly called luciferase gene, which produces luciferase, it is an enzyme that will express bioluminescence, which make it emit light, and put it into a tobacco plant, that plant will also emit light. What if we put this gene into the gene that codes for your skin? Maybe now you can get that glowing skin you ever dream of. Who needs the 10-step Korean skincare routine anymore, right? These are the definition that you need to know along the way. Recombinant DNA is the DNA that contains gene from different sources that have been combined by the technique of genetic engineering. Here we're gonna make recombinant DNA means we're gonna cut and recombine DNA. How cool is that? Recombinant DNA technology is the technology of preparing recombinant DNA in vitro by cutting up DNA molecule and splicing together fragments from more than one organism. Genetic engineering is the process of changing the genetic makeup of an organism by introducing DNA from another organism. The word introducing here means you're gonna insert another DNA into another DNA. Transgenic organism means organism whose genetic characteristics have been altered by the insertion of desirable gene from another organism using the technique of genetic engineering. The word desirable here means the gene that we wanted, just like luciferase. So tool used in gene cloning are target DNA, restriction enzyme, DNA cloning vector, modifying enzyme, and host cell. So as an engineer in genetic cloning, you're gonna need all these tools. Target DNA or gene of interest is the fragment of chromosomal DNA to be cloned. DNA is actually very, very long and vast. So probably there's only a part of it that you wanted to be cloned into another, such as this one, an example, luciferase gene. We're gonna take it. So that is what we call it as the target DNA. Next one is restriction enzymes. The restriction enzyme is an endonuclease. It is a class of enzyme that recognize and cleave DNA molecule at specific nucleotide sequence, the restriction site. So this is the enzyme. It will recognize the restriction site and then it will cut it there, leaving a sticky end or a blunt end depending on the type of restriction enzyme. Each restriction enzyme are specific to their restriction site. Restriction site are usually palindromic. Examples of restriction enzyme that cleave and produce sticky end fragment are EcoR1, which come from Escherichia coli. It cuts in between G and A of the first strand, and another strand it cuts between the G and A. BAMH1 came from Bacillus amylocoefficient, cuts between G and G of the first strand, and another strand cuts between G and G. Examples of restriction enzyme that cleave and produce blunt end would be SMA1, which comes from Serratia marcescens, which cut in between C and G and G and C of the other strand. The next tool is DNA cloning vector. It is an agent or a small DNA molecule derived from plasmid, bacteriophage, cosmid, or yak. It carries or contains foreign DNA fragment or the gene of interest, which to be introduced into host cell. A vector just like this mosquito here, a vector for dengue, means it carries dengue virus. So a vector basically means carrier. There are four types of vector: plasmid, bacteriophage, cosmid, and yak. Plasmid, as example, part 18, it can carry around 10 to 15 kilobases pair. It have origin of replication, that enables it to replicate independently, multiple cloning site, also known as polylinker. which enabling it to accept foreign DNA by cutting here and then combine the DNA of interest in here. And it also have genetic marker, which is a selectable gene useful for screening. Next factor is the bacteriophage. As example here, Lambda 2001, it can carry bigger DNA molecule, which is around 25 kilo base pair. It is an agent for carrying foreign DNA segment. So it have a DNA which it will inject into host. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this out and replace it with DNA of interest. Cosmid can carry 44 kilo base pair, and it have origin of replication, multiple cloning site, and marker. The difference is it can carry larger molecule of DNA compared to plasmid. Next one is PYAG. It can carry even larger DNA molecule, which is 500 kilo base. So it have the same quality, which is the ORI, origin of replication, which allow it to replicate independently. And then multiple cloning site, also known as the polylinker, where it will accept the foreign DNA, and then the genetic marker, which useful in screening. To sum up, there are four types of cloning vector: plasmid, example here PAC18, which can carry around 10 to 15 kilobase; bacteriophage, example Lambda 2001, which can carry bigger, 25 kilobases; the cosmid, which can carry 44 kilobase; and YAC, yeast artificial chromosome, or plasmid yet, PYAG, can carry a larger one, which is 500 kilobase. The next tool is host cell. So the host cell are cell in which recombinant DNA can be replicated or recombinant protein can be produced. The word recombinant DNA here refer to the DNA that have been altered. Plasmid is a DNA and it is a vector. So that plasmid is being cut and then inserted with the gene of interest. So it is now altered, and that's why it is called recombinant, where you recombine DNA. So that when you got recombinant DNA, means you can produce recombinant protein. The most commonly used host organism is the bacterium Escherichia coli. This is important because without the host, the DNA cannot do anything, because DNA is just an information. When you put it into a cell, then only the cell can produce the product, which is the protein. So most commonly is the Escherichia coli, because the plasmid come from Escherichia coli. What is a good host? The host must be able to receive DNA recombinant, able to maintain the structure of the DNA recombinant, able to amplify the gene product from DNA recombinant. The next tool is modifying enzyme. So modifying enzyme used in modifying the DNA strand. So now you have your DNA strand, you wanted to recombine it and everything. So we're gonna use modifying enzyme. An example of modifying enzyme is DNA ligase and tag polymerase. The DNA ligase joins DNA fragment together by forming 4-fold diester bond. It is like a glue where it produces phosphodiester bond, making the DNA functional. Tag polymerase used to replace DNA polymerase in polymerase chain reaction, PCR, method of amplifying short segment of DNA. Tag polymerase is basically a DNA polymerase. That's all for now. See you in the next lecture. Keep it up, guys.